This video shows how to conduct the AnyLogic Compare Runs experiment. This experiment allows you to input the model parameters, run the simulation, and visualize its output using the charts. After running several simulations in a row, you can compare the obtained results visually. We'll use the influenza model, which you can find in the healthcare section of AnyLogic's example models. This model describes the influenza outbreak within 100 families. Initially, 3 random people are infected. Infection is then transmitted with a defined probability during contacts that can happen at home and at work. To create a compare runs experiment, you need the main diagram to contain at least one parameter. In our experiment, we're going to explore the infection probability effect on the influenza dynamics. This parameter defines the probability of a person to be infected during contact with sick people. It's a numeric parameter with a certain range of values, so we can improve the model usability by changing the control type to slider instead of the text field, and set its min and max values to 0 and 1. Note that the parameter you plan to use in the compare runs experiment must be one of the following data types: double, integer, string, or boolean. Now, let's ensure that our model has the necessary outputs that will allow us to compare the results of the runs. The model includes the nsick variable, which stores the current number of sick people, and the nsickds dataset that stores the influenza dynamics data. The dataset is configured to use time as horizontal axis value and use the nsick variable as the vertical axis value. This allows us to monitor the number of sick people at each specific moment of time. We're ready to create the experiment. In the Projects view, right-click the model and choose New, Experiment. In the opened wizard, select Compare Runs in the Experiment Type list. Now, we need to set the experiment parameters. We'll use the infection probability parameter only, so we select it in the available list and add it to the experiment by clicking the Add button. Next, we'll set up the charts that will serve as the experiment outputs. The first chart will display several influenza dynamic curves, one per model run. In the Type field, we choose Dataset. We'll call our chart Influenza Dynamics. In the Expression field, type root.nsickds. Here, we use root to refer to the model's main agent, and then we provide the name of the dataset to refer to the dataset itself. Let's create one more chart to display the pandemic peak level. Note that this chart displays a single value for each model run. In the chart's type field, choose value. We'll call our chart pandemic peak level. Type the following expression: root .nsickds.getymax. Here, we obtain the dataset's maximum value along the y-axis, which, as you can remember, stores the number of sick people. The experiment's ready. We can click Finish. AnyLogic will create the experiment and generate the default user interface for it. Note that the compare runs experiment requires stop time to be defined. Otherwise, the first model run will be infinite. We'll limit the simulation period to 30 days, which seems to be sufficient for our case. Let's run the experiment. The left part of the window displays the number of performed model runs and contains the slider to adjust the infection probability parameter. The right part contains the charts that display the simulation output. We'll leave the default infection probability intact and perform the first run. Here's our first set of values. Now, we'll perform more runs with increased probability for each subsequent run. To highlight the output of a specific run, click its name in the chart legend. Note that this action also displays the input values that were used for this specific run. You can right-click a legend item and select Copy Selected to copy the selected result, or Copy All to copy all results. Now, you can paste the data to a spreadsheet for statistical analysis. Thanks for watching. Come back for more AnyLogic how-to videos.